Welcome to the spoken tutorial on introduction to GNStream. In this tutorial, we will learn what is GNStream, how to use GNStream, how to use ping command. To record this tutorial, I am using Ubuntu 11.04 as the operating system. Software required GNStream version 0.7.4 and VPCS. User should have basic knowledge of networking, knowledge of terminal commands. Let me brief you about GNStream. GNStream stands for Graphical Network Simulator. It is an open source simulator. It can be installed using Synaptic Package Manager. I have already installed it on my PC. To learn more, watch spoken tutorial on Synaptic Package Manager. Let me brief you about VPCS. VPCS stands for Virtual PC Simulator. It is used in GNStream as virtual PC. To download VPCS file, go to the URL shown here. To do this, I have already opened Mozilla web browser with the given URL. Let me switch to the Mozilla web browser. Now I will press enter as I have already the URL. You will find a download window will be opened in a few seconds. It depends on your internet speed. Now select the save file and click on OK. File is downloaded. Now open a terminal by pressing Alt Ctrl T keys simultaneously on your keyboard. Let me adjust the terminal to the view area. Now type command cd space downloads and press enter. Type ls to view your downloaded file. This is the file in zip format. To unzip the file, type command unzip space name of the file and press enter. Now change your directory to unzipped file by typing command cd space 0.21a is the name of directory and press enter. Type ls and press enter to view different files in the directory. To make VPCS32 executable, type command sudo space chmod space plus x space VPCS32 and press enter. Type sudo password and press enter. To run VPCS, type command sudo space dot slash VPCS32 and press enter. You will find message can't find DHCP server as VPCS required IP. We will manually configure the IP. So press Ctrl C to get back to the VPCS prompt. We can configure up to 9 virtual PCs, but for the tutorial I will configure only 2 virtual PCs. Now to assign IP address, type command IP space 10.1.1.10 is my desired IP address, /8 is the subnet mask and press enter. To enter second VPCS, type 2 and press enter. To assign IP, type command IP space 10.1.1.11 is the IP address and /8 is the subnet mask. Press enter. IP configuration is completed. Let me switch to the slide. To connect GNStream with virtual clouds, run GNStream with root access. To do this, I will again switch to my terminal and open a new terminal by pressing Ctrl Shift T keys simultaneously on my keyboard. Now type command sudo space GNStream to run GNStream and press enter. Type sudo password and press enter. You will find a window titled New Project is open. You will be asked to save the project with a name. For the time being, I will not name it, but click on cancel. Now let me use a magnifier to make the font size bigger. To the left side, you will find nodes types pane. It contains different nodes used in GNS3. For the tutorial, I will use Ethernet switch and cloud listed at the last. At the top, you will find the toolbar. To the right, you will find topology summary pane. And at the center, we have workspace area. Now I will again switch to my original view. Let me now show you how to use these nodes in the workspace. Let us create a network topology. Click on Ethernet switch, drag and drop to the workspace area. Now click on cloud, drag and drop to workspace area, drag another cloud and drop to the workspace area. Now double click on C1. A node configurator window is opened. Select C1. Click on add. You will find a port is added to the left side. To the right side. I will show it by using a magnifier. This is the port which is added to the right side. I will again switch to my original view. Now click on OK to close window. Now double click on C2. Again a node configurator window is opened. Click on C2. This time increase the local port value by 1. Increase the remote port value by 1 and click on add. You will find a port is added to the right side. Let me use a magnifier to make it bigger. This is the port which is added. Now I will again switch to my original view. Close the window by clicking on OK. Now I will use a link to connect these nodes. To do this, go to the toolbar, move to the 9th position from left, click on add a link. Select manual, mouse cursor change to plus, click on Ethernet switch, select the port, expand the link, click on C1, select the port. Now repeat the process for C2, click on Ethernet switch, select the port, click on C2 and select the port. You will find green bubbles appears. This means nodes are connected. Now I will again click on add a link to make mouse cursor normal. To the topology summary, you will find the connection between different nodes. Let me show it by using a magnifier. This is the topology summary with every connection. Let me again switch to the original view. Now we will see the connectivity between C1 and C2 using ping command. To do this, I will again switch to the terminal. I will switch to my VPCS terminal and type command ping, which is used to check the connectivity, and type the IP of my first VPCS, that is 10.1.1.10, and press enter. You will find ICMP reply packets coming from VPCS 1. Now type 1 and press enter to enter first VPCS. We are in first VPCS. Now type command ping space IP address of second VPCS, that is 10.1.1.11, and press enter. You will find the ICMP reply packets coming from second VPCS. This means that both the machines are connected with each other using the switch. Let me again switch to GNS3. Here we have learned a basic concept of networking by creating a simulation of nodes using GNS3. This brings us to the end of this tutorial. To summarize, we have learned how to add a node on workspace, configuring VPCS and its ports, designing a topology, using ping command to check the connectivity. Assignment for the tutorial: create a topology for 3 machines using a switch. Check connectivity using ping command. Watch the video available at the link below. It summarizes the spoken tutorial project. If you do not have good bandwidth, you can download and watch it. The spoken tutorial project team conducts workshops using spoken tutorials, gives certificates to those who pass an online test. For more details, write to contact@spoken-tutorial.org. Spoken Tutorial Project is a part of the Talk to a Teacher project. It is supported by the National Mission on Education through ICT-MHRD Government of India. More information on this mission is available at the link below. This is Amit Srivastav from IIT Bombay signing off. Thanks for joining.